realize, I just want to say to my friend Paul Tonko, thank you for your leadership, because I was serving in the House when Paul was elected, and all of you who follow his record know this, but he hit the ground running when it came to clean energy, renewable energy, energy efficiency. He became a leader in the House right away, so it's great to catch up by my friend Paul Tonko. Paul, thank you for all your efforts. It's great to see all of you. Scott, thank you for your leadership. To all the folks who are part of the Sustainable Energy Coalition, EESI, and to my friends who are part of the Energy Efficiency and Renewable Energy Caucus. You may be hearing later from the co-chairs from both the House and the Senate. I was pleased to serve, Scott said, as one of the House co-chairs, and now very pleased as a member of the Senate to be participating with all of you in this effort. Whenever I come here, I get very optimistic and excited about the future, because it really is in your hands. The people who are on the ground level of innovation, the entrepreneurs, the people who spend every day and you know, sleepless nights thinking about the next new technology invention that's going to help us both have a healthier country, a healthier planet, and put a whole lot of people to work in the United States of America in good paying jobs. And it's our job in the United States Congress to make sure that we do everything we can to support that effort, and certainly don't do things that will hinder that effort. And so I am pleased, not only that this is a bipartisan caucus, but in the United States Senate, I now serve on the Senate Appropriations Committee, and there was a bipartisan agreement that we should reject many of the proposed cuts that were put forward by the Trump administration that would have done grave damage at the Department of Energy, whether it was DARPA-E or the other programs that many of you may work with over the Department of Energy and in other agencies. And the good news is that because of the years where you participated in building a bipartisan coalition here, we've been able to protect those important investments, as we have, with your help, been able to protect the important tax incentives that provide some boost both to wind and solar and other renewable and energy efficiency projects. So thank all of you for working on both sides of the aisle to get that done. As Scott said, there are some long-term things we need to continue to push for, in my mind, like a cap and dividend proposal to really capture the price of carbon emissions and make sure that we have more of a polluter pays principle. But I think all of us know that that's an ongoing effort, and it's important that we keep pushing, because when we do have the opportunity to move forward, we have to have a plan that we all unite behind. But I just want to say one word about Maryland. I don't have any Marylanders in the House. All right, got some Marylanders in the House. You may not know this, but Maryland is really moving ahead in the area of offshore wind. We have not just one offshore wind project, but two offshore wind projects off of Ocean City that are in the final stages of federal approval. This is very good news. It's about 370 megawatts of energy that would be produced by these wind farms, offshore wind farms. We are trying to make sure that nobody messes this up as we get to the final stages. And as a member of the Appropriations Committee in the Senate, I'm going to make sure that one of these poison pill riders that was put on here in the House that would actually derail those projects, that does not get on the final bill. We need to make sure that's not on the final bill. So, and in the area of trying to at least not do bad things, we are working, I know Senator Heinrich may be here later, to try to roll back the tariffs that were put on solar panels. Look, we all want to develop a strong solar industry, both here at home, but also make sure that we expand the major industries that are involved in installation of solar panels and others. And as all of you probably know, those tariffs have already resulted in job losses around the country, including in my state of Maryland. So as we work together to try to do good things, let's also work together to try and prevent these bad things from dragging us backwards. So again, let me close where I started, which is this is the place that makes me optimistic. That's why I like to come here and look at all the things that you're working on, because we just try to set the policy that provides a constructive sort of playing field for all of you. But we would not advance if it wasn't for the brain power that all of you bring to this. And as I said, the job creation and incredible opportunities that are out there for good paying jobs. So thank you all very much. Great to be here, and keep up the good work.